DozhaToldya.com.
It's your boy Dame Doja of the Doja Told You Podcast. This is number 64. Sorry for the technical difficulties. Number 64. We are back in the building. And let me get my applause, man. Let me get my love, man. Show the boy some love. Number 64. We back, man. Live, man. On the Twitch, on YouTube. Follow, subscribe, and appreciate all the likes and all the love that y'all been giving, man. Before we left off, we was talking about the Met Gala, and that was fun, man. The camera messed up, but they was definitely on camera, and there was a lot of folks that was on point. Also, we ain't really talked too much about the new music that came out, but I've been listening to the new Jack Harlow, man. Y'all go check out the new Jack Harlow. That shit is definitely on point. Tony Red dropping some new music. He ain't sent it to me yet, man. I don't know, man. I ain't seen Tony Red in the building either, man. I think Tony Red mad at me, man. Somebody check in on Tony Red for me one of these. Don't say it. I don't know what's going on. But I ain't talked to him in a minute. But he also got a show tomorrow that I'm damn not going to miss. And that's probably where he might mad. But download the Encore app. We're supposed to be watching the show on the Encore app. So definitely going to check that out tomorrow. So most folks, by the time you see this, you probably will have missed the show. But what's the new song that these folks done dropped? I can't even remember the name of the song. Actually, it's T. Givens, Tony Red, and Chula Ramon is on the song. I think it's called like Scary Hours or something like that. But yeah, definitely heard the Tony Red, man. Come in, Tony Red. It's called Swear to God. Swear to God, Scary Hours. They're the same thing. Scary Hours, Swear to God. Same thing, right? All right, so, but it was plenty more that we have to talk about, you guys. So y'all ready, you know? What else? Where can we start? Rest in peace to Jordan Neely. And people are demanding justice for Jordan Neely. He was the subway homeless, the homeless man on the subway in New York City, was strangled to death. And just like a little a fight, a dispute, I think he was kind of just being a nuisance on the subway. And I seen a bit of it on camera. I tried to avoid this one, so I really didn't catch it. But social media demands justice after a homeless man is choked to death on a New York subway train by another passenger. Many people have taken to social media for justice for Jordan Neely, 30, as a video showed him being choked to death on New York on a New York train. I don't have food. I don't have drink. I'm fed up. I don't mind going to jail and getting life in prison. I'm ready to die. An African American yelled as he was removed, as he removed his robe and aggressively whipped it to the floor of the wagon. Oh, I thought they was going to say he whipped it out. He aggressively whipped it to the floor of the wagon. The silence let the breaths be heard above the traditional noise of tires spinning on the tracks. The whistleblower jumped into the train that was about to close its doors on 2nd Avenue and started with a tangent, heartbreaking performance that prompted the flee of those around him. Since I still had it about 4 meters away and other passengers in the middle, I didn't move from my place. Desperation and mental illness have always been a bad mix as cake and gravy. Before the show will go on, although so far in the disturbed did not seem to want to attack anyone. A young man with brown hair and gray shawl grabbed him by the neck and laid him on the floor as he tied him with his legs. They were in that position for about 15 minutes while other passengers and train operators called the police, as heard in the video. The uniforms, by the way, never arrived. And as now the captain struggled to escape the key, other Samaritans stepped in to aid the warrior and prevent the other from escaping. One of them who had recently tackled was recently tackled with a woman seemed to mediate between the two fighting on the floor. I had a date at Yonkers, so when they released the captive already unarmed, I left the scene and stopped filming. At the end, you can see how aggressive the man stands idle after tenacity in his neck and the consequence that reminded me of George Floyd's. All right. So everybody just stood there, got it on tape. Say the man was a Michael Jackson impersonator who I guess had enough. I don't know, man. I'm glad I ain't really show the video either. I don't even want to really even see the video, to tell you the truth. But it was a sad situation, and Jordan Neely, justice for George Neely, and rest in peace to Jordan Neely. Yeah, it's like, I came right back with sad news. I came right back with sad news, didn't I? I was like, damn, Doja, didn't you just leave from the sad news, and then you said you weren't going to come back with it, but then you came right back with it. All right, Henry Ruggs. Former Raiders star Henry Ruggs agrees to prison sentence for DUI case. He can possibly face 3 to 10 years in jail. Man, definitely Alabama, former Alabama wide receiver and Oakland Raider. I'm not Oakland Raider, excuse me, Las Vegas Raider. Always will be Oakland. Las Vegas Raider Henry Ruggs was in a car accident after he was driving drunk in Las Vegas, doing very, very dangerous high speeds of over 100 miles per hour. And yeah, he killed folks. And he facing 3 to 10 years. I ain't even enough time to tell you the truth. But at the same time, yeah, I guess justice was served. I ain't even gonna say that there ain't enough time. I guess just that's just how justice is. But 3 to 10 years, we'll see how much time he gets. Actuality, Henry Ruggs made a real, real big mistake, unfortunately, and rest in peace to the victims in that case. Yeah, man. All right, so keeping it moving, I'm saying, like I said, this part of the show, we always, you know, get a little darker than usual. I that's just how it be, you know. It be a little darker than usual, you know what I'm saying? But where we going? Where we going to play? Okay, we good. Celina Powell alleges that she was intimate with Lil Meech. So meanwhile, you know what I'm saying? Y'all might not even know. But Lil Meech, before this even happened, Lil Meech and Summer Walker, you know what I'm saying, have been sneaking around. And you know where it was that they were dating. You know, Summer Walker got her another one. No, she got her another one. She got her another one, man. Damn. Lil Meech. BMF gonna be on R&B tapes. The BMF gonna be on R&B. R&B album. But yeah, man. They actually a good looking couple, actually. But somebody tried to ruin their happiness. Celina Powell. OnlyFans actress or OnlyFans sex worker Celina Powell went out posting, you know what I'm saying, posting a video of her giving fellatio and sexual favors to allegedly to Lil Meech. Pause. Nah, but yeah, Celina Powell, you know, tried to break up the happy home. But meanwhile, the couple has been seen looking very, very happy, actually. They've been posting, you know what I'm saying, little silly pictures together, you know. Then I stunting, this girl, they're not stunting the girl to trying to bring darkness to their life. Excuse me, my bad. I was reading something. I got thrown off. But yeah, they ain't stunting you, girl. Go on ahead somewhere. Lil Meech and Summer Walker gonna have a hell of a summer together. You know what I'm saying? They gonna enjoy their summer together. Okay, also on serious news. I know, because I be having a whole show planned out before this, right? I be having a whole show planned out in my head, and then I get to go to executing the show, and then that shit don't never go as I think it's going to go. Anyway, I'm going to try to remember what I was going to try to get back into. A manhunt is underway after five people was killed. 8-year-old was shot almost execution style in Cleveland, Texas, home on Friday night. So yeah, the killer that was killed five people, I think it was like neighbors in Texas. So his name is they calling it a Texas massacre in San Jacinto, Jacinto County, or Cleveland, Texas, whatever you want to consider it. Hold on, let's see if we got a video. We might have a video, y'all. We might have a video brought to you by ABC Channel 13. Shout out to them folks. Let me get this music slowed down. Let's stop this music real quick. All right. So yeah. How early is this? This is not early enough. No, this is old. We need something that's. I guess this was yesterday. We need one that was yesterday. Cause they done caught, buddy. All right, we done switched up.
Three deodorant myths ruining your game. Myth number one, natural.
We gonna go to Fox News. Man, we gonna go to Fox News. Hold on. What dude name is, man? I don't even know. He on a $5 million bond. At least they gave him a bond. It's been a lot of, matter of fact, I almost forget to talk about the Atlanta mass shooting. I mean, this is, the mass shooting part of the show. It usually happen like that, don't it? Don't it usually happen like that? Like, part two is always with the bullshit. Like, we always got to cover the bullshit.
Is over tonight.
Part two. Video captured Francisco Oropesa in a police car. He is charged with 5 counts of murder, accused of killing 5 members of the same family after they asked him to stop firing a gun in his yard.
The arrest happening in Cut and Shoot in Montgomery County, just about 11 miles from the crime scene in San Jacinto County.
Our team is all over this breaking news tonight.
We wanted to begin, though, with ABC 13's Daniela Hurtado, who has the facts on the arrest that ended this 4-day manhunt. Daniela?
Erica, we're on Summer Hollow Drive right now, the home where this suspect, Francisco Oropesa, was found. Law enforcement just moments ago confirmed he was found inside of this home, hiding in a closet under laundry. Now, other details that they tell us is that thankfully no one was hurt during this. There was no incident with the suspect. They were able to get him out, arrest him, and since has been taken to jail. Now, we have seen people across this entire community across this entire community is what I meant, out here looking, watching, taking photos, taking videos of this entire situation. They were the ones out here during that arrest as well. You mentioned the last 4 days have been crazy for the San Jacinto County area. Many of the people were on edge, scared, and tonight they finally have some answers on where that suspect is and some reassurance that suspect is now behind bars. Now, again, he was found inside this home hiding. We're still waiting for more information on what connection he has to this home. Of course, we have learned that there may be some familiar connection. We've asked those questions. And actually, I want to take you guys now to reporter Jessica Willie, who asked questions to those law enforcement agencies just moments ago during that news conference. She's live now at the command post in San Jacinto.
Yeah, Daniela, that big official announcement coming from San Jacinto County Sheriff Greg Capers around 9 o'clock tonight. He released some details about how they found this murder suspect. The FBI says they've gotten more than 200 tips over the last few days. The one this evening panned out. Orpeso arrested by U.S. Marshals, DPS, and attack team from Border Patrol at that home where Daniela is. Somehow he managed to elude police for 4 days. That's something authorities are not answering questions
about. 4 days.
Did he have help? Will others face charges? Also, have
they had a good little run going, bro. 4 days. Well, I know, boy, you woke up the first day.
Those were told it's an ongoing investigation. This house is the area that's been searched before and only 11 miles from the crime scene where the sheriff says he shot and killed five of his neighbors, including a boy in the third grade. Hundreds of tips were received over the last few days. The information this evening funneled to the field for that arrest.
We received the tip at 5:15 p.m. and the arrest was made at 6:30 p.m. I can just tell you that we're just extremely happy that the citizen had the courage and the bravery to call in that tip.
And here again, video from their arrest. Also questions about previous charges and deportations, though authorities tried to serve a warrant from 2022 related to a protective order violation at a house, in fact, in the same neighborhood where he was arrested tonight. They say they were never able to find him. Orpeso was taken.
Tip at 5:15 p.m. and the arrest was made at 6:30 p.m.
Field for that arrest.
We received the tip at 5:15 p.m. and the arrest was
before and only 11 miles from the
rest in peace, man. Very sad story. Diana Alvarado Abdulia Rivera, Jesus Caceres, Daniel Guzman, and Sonia Talbot. All right, moving right along. I won't even say it like that. Sorry to even say it like that, but it's been a lot of crazy stuff going on this week. So yeah, it was a mass shooting. If another mass shooting in Atlanta, guess we might as well get into that since we're talking about, you know, as we are talking about the shootings and stuff like that. So let's get into that one. I seen something on the internet, whatever, like kind of earlier that day. Somebody was like, you know, all I seen folks was like, somebody put the warning out, like, get off the streets. And things just kind of looked kind of different, whatever. You know, I was out a little bit, but then I ain't go downtown. And downtown and midtown, there was a suspect. And, you know, when you hear about these mass shootings, it's starting to be like every week is a American, you know, it's an American tradition, seemingly. And that's mass shootings. It's very, very disgusting. It's very bad of our society. But, you know, whether or not they say it's the guns is the problem or people are the problem, we have a problem, you know. Or is it, you know, mental health, as they say. This was a Deion Patterson is the assailant. And they say that he was a veteran, and I don't know, probably the Coast Guard or something. I don't know. They say he was of service to the country, and he was under medication, and you know, you can blame some of that on the vet care, but whatever it is, you know, we really have a lot of issues in this country when it comes to violence and gun violence in particular. So let's see what this what happened. Let's hear from NBC.
This morning in Atlanta, gunman no longer on the run. This video capturing the moment police caught up with Deion Patterson. The 24-year-old, authorities say, unleashed a deadly rampage in a hospital, launching a massive, nearly day-long manhunt.
an undercover officer was the one that originally saw and confronted this individual.
Police arresting Patterson after Wednesday's attack at Atlanta's Northside Hospital, where investigators say he pulled out a handgun and started shooting.
They're now advising the active shooter, a person shot.
The violent scene playing out in an 11th floor waiting room, where police say Patterson fired a hail of bullets, killing one victim. Identified as 39-year-old Amy St. Pierre, a CDC employee. Four other women were also injured. According to police, Patterson was with his mother for an unknown medical appointment, but she was not hurt during the shooting. The active shooter call placed the bustling area on lockdown, which impacted several schools, including one attended by Georgia Senator Raphael Warnock's children.
They're there, I'm here. Hoping and praying that they are safe. But the truth is, none of us is safe.
Barely 30 minutes after opening fire, license plate recognition cameras spotted a vehicle the shooter stole 20 miles away, near Truist Park, where the Atlanta Braves play.
Those cameras proved extremely helpful today. That is where we got the precise location of the building that he walked into.
Patterson, a former member of the U.S. Coast Guard, had been discharged from active duty in January after nearly 5 years of service. Today, the motive for the shooting remains unclear. Authorities only saying they don't believe any of the victims were targeted.
This was a horrible act of gun violence. But equally horrifying is that we know that this is not unique in our country.
And this morning, we are still awaiting updates on the conditions of those four victims in a nearby Atlanta hospital. As for any criminal past involving Patterson, Atlanta police would only say that they had minimal contact with the 24-year-old prior to the shooting. Hoda.
All right, Morgan Chesky for us there. Morgan, thank you.
That's brought to you by, NBC News. You know what I'm saying? Thank you for the NBC News. Mental health is definitely an issue here in our country. Prayers to the victims that was affected and everybody that worked at that Northside Medical. And yeah, it's just terrible. Shameful. Deion Patterson is a piece of shit. And at least they got him. I actually was driving over there in that area or whatever. I did actually see them blocking off. I had to deliver. They had that place blocked off. I understand why they had that exact building blocked off now. That's actually ironic. Very, very ironic. Just to make me feel a little better, I'm just going to look at this for a little while. Let's just look at this. Everybody that's watching us on Twitch, I just can't get enough of this video. Goodness gracious. Shout out to Janelle Monae. Shout out to Janelle Monae. All right, so keeping it moving. Yeah, America is really, we got issues, man. We definitely got issues. The game on, so I ain't gonna keep y'all that long, man. I know y'all watching the game. Matter of fact, what's the score? Matter of fact, I understand. The game on, and y'all could just check this out. The game just started. Lakers versus Warriors. Who y'all got, man? Tonight, man. LeBron played a pretty good game last week. I mean, it's actually not LeBron. I mean, Anthony Davis played a good game. Excuse me. The new LeBron of the team, Anthony Davis. Now, LeBron is aged, but he's playing great defense. The whole team's playing great defense, Vanderbilt. And they didn't shoot very well. LeBron needs to start shooting so many threes, though. It definitely was crazy watching him shoot them threes like that. Because But they had the paint on shutdown. Steph Curry and them did eat a 14-point lead up in the fourth and almost took it. And everybody was talking about the Jordan Poole shot heard around the world, or not heard around the world, rather. And Jordan Poole missed that shot last week. I mean, a few days ago.
Also, shout out to the Panthers, Florida Panthers, they in the playoffs. Shout out to them. They up 3-2 versus the Maple Leafs. We in there, Florida. You know what I'm saying? Nobody ain't even talk about the Panthers. You know what I'm saying? Nobody ain't talking about NHL hockey. Who talking about it? We is, shouty, right here on the Doja Toja Podcast, man. Appreciate y'all for listening. What else I meant to talk about? There's a lot of things. I wanted to talk about the issues that we have in America, man, the con that America kind of tries to get you to believe in. But I really lost my mental space for the rant that I had to go on. And this, so I'm basically just going to give it a short version. America is just basically just, we like the con. Everything's a con. We and a scam. And until we start being real with some of the issues that we all have, and I'm saying whether it's reparations, whether it's the lies, whether it's the politics, the media, it's just so many things that's just so sold to you that is not as it seems. It's very hard. The 9-to-5 dream that you'll save your money up. The banking system, you know what I'm saying? The banks failing, and whether or not, you know what I'm saying, the banks being exposed. It's just so much going on these days that just kind of just makes you just really, really question where we at in the society, whatever, man. Because the American scam, man, is really whoever could really scam the best, man. Whoever could scam the hardest. Because one minute you hear people talking to them, you know what I'm saying, in front of people or whatever in the Met Gala, and everybody is friendly and hunky dory, and then next minute behind the closed doors, they're racist. They're calling them saying, you know, it's all a scam. Like, they're running a scam, a real good one, an elaborate scheme scam. And everybody, whoever's the best scam artist is the one who pulling it off, unfortunately. You know, there's a lot of them out there. We were just saying Jonathan Majors was, you know what I'm saying, also great in the movies. I just went, well, saying two in the same year, and almost within a three-month span, he went from being, you know, praised and paraded around the country and put on every publication and every media outlet. Then the scam, the gag was he was supposedly and allegedly a domestic abuse assault of women, or however you can just name it. He was just a villain for real. And so it's just all weird, man. The scam of America. They sell you these scams. You know, why they even call it small business? Why is that even a thing? Small business. When you get a small business loan, why even call it small business? Who wants a business to be small? Why are you trying to convince me that a business should be small, America? Why? I posted some jobs the other day. It's the end of the first. It's 33-26 Lakers. But I posted some jobs the other day on my timeline. And one of my dogs, you know what I'm saying, you know, actually posted these jobs. And then one, it was like starting at $17 an hour. And this is in Atlanta. But one of my friends was like, $17 an hour, that's crazy. And he had a good point. He was like, that's crazy, like that. They're trying people like that. But they're running a scam. Let these folks think that they, you know, that, yeah, we got your back. We got your back. folks running a straight scheme scam, man, on everybody, man. We home of the scammers. Nah, that's really Nigeria, they say. I need to meet somebody from Nigeria. Folks skim scamming. All right, also on news, man, Texas man accused of pausing a date to kill fake parking lot attendant who over a $40 scam. There you go. And here you go, one guy who finally was tired of the scamming. He had enough. He said he was out on a date. 29-year-old Eric Aguirre appeared in court Thursday on murder charges stemming from the death of 46-year-old Elliot Nix. According to court records, Eric allegedly chased Elliot down and shot him after discovering that Elliot was working as a fake parking lot. As a fake parking lot attendant and scammed Eric out of $40. This boy crashed out over $40. His bond is set for $200,000, baby. You know what I'm saying? I hope baby go get his date, get his work up his and why she gonna get the money. She gonna get the money to get him out of jail. Eric then returned to the restaurant, allegedly telling his date that everything was fine and that he had just scared the man. Eric appeared in court on Thursday. His bond is set at $200,000. This news is brought to you by the Shade Room. Yeah, man, $40. Shout out to DJ Dozier, says, yeah, he crashed out over $40. Eric Aguirre, he ain't taking that, man. He ain't tired of it. He just got fed up with being scammed with the mafia. I mean, with the scam of America. He got scared. It was $40. It ain't matter what it was. He just was like, you ain't gonna scam me. And he was armed, though, because he was an American. You know why the Americans got to be armed? We have the right to bear arms. And so, yeah, Eric ran down on him, walked down on him like he was listening to an NBA young boy. And rest in peace, Elliot Nix, man. We ain't trying to, make fun of the actual incident, but he was out there scamming folks as a fake parking attendant. And folks think it's sweet out here. And, you know, what happens when the retaliation happens? You know? What happens when the retaliation happens? There's consequences. Niggas out here playing with people. And playing with people and their money. So, yeah, man. Eric Aguirre, tired of the scam. American. We'll scam the hell out of your ass. Taxes, man. Scam, man. You pay taxes on everything, though. You know, sales tax, property tax, driving tax, parking tax, road taxes, tolls, FICA. State tax. Shout out to. Let me make you feel better about taxes real quick, man. Make y'all feel better, man. Yeah. Make me feel better, girl. Make me feel better. Make me feel better, girl. Make me feel better. Yeah. Shout out to Janelle Monae, man. I gotta get some money. Ooh. Make me feel better about the scam, man. Make me feel better about the scam, man. I'ma shoot this nigga for $40, and I'm gonna come back and tell you everything's fine if we out on a date, girl, because you make me feel better. You make me feel better. Yeah. Alright, man, I'm getting distracted, man. I digress. That's definitely the video of the week, man. Janelle Monae getting it in, man, on top of a bar. Yes. Alright, man, I know the game on, man, so I'm gonna have y'all out of here in about 10 minutes, man. So, yeah, hey, we watched Ebony K. Williams. Okay, can we get some good news here? Enrique Tarrio, guilty of seditious conspiracy. Leader of the Proud Boys, This is brought to you by Wall Street Journal.
Supremacists and right-wing militia groups in a September presidential debate.
Stand back and
stand down.
But I'll tell you what.
Stand by.
Somebody's got to do something about Antifa and the left.
The moment emboldened the group. Its leader, Enrique Tarrio, posted a message on social media shortly after, saying simply, "Standing by, sir." It has been widely reported
that we ready?
Plan to attend a rally at the Capitol on January 6th to protest election results. Joe Biggs, another leader, called for violence on social media.
All right, guys, you want to see all the Proud Boys that are here today? Here we go. Everybody cover up!
And everybody might not know
more than 100 Proud
that Enrique, the leader of the Proud Boys, is actually black. Yes. Gag is, he's black.
Black is channeled.
A Proud Boy live stream.
And January 6th was put together by also a black guy.
They met and coordinated.
I know, right?
Block declined to comment.
I know, exactly.
In the morning,
the original Trump rally, not the raid.
The Proud Boys meet on the east side of the Capitol. Biggs can be seen organizing groups of Proud Boys. He's equipped with a radio.
If you're on the outside, making sure you're looking on the outside of the perimeter, we're sneaking up on us.
Biggs has since been arrested, and charging documents say he aided, abetted, and commanded others to unlawfully enter the Capitol.
Oh,
man.
They got him.
Biggs and his attorney did not respond to multiple requests for comment.
Milkshake's afraid of me because I'm going to kick his ass off.
Dan Scott, a Proud Boy known as Milkshake, can be heard shouting. But is chastised by others.
Let's not fucking yell that, all right?
It's Milkshake, yeah. Idiot.
Don't yell it, do it.
Scott did not respond to multiple requests for comment. Some individuals who would hours later participate in the riot can be seen taking part in the rendezvous.
They got him.
There's Michael Porter, who identified himself to the Journal as a Proud Boy. This man, whose identity the Journal could not fully confirm,
these folks recorded themselves doing the stupid
documents, can be seen with the group throughout the day, instigating the mob. And Robert Gieswein, who's also with the group throughout the day and is wearing patches suggesting affiliation with Proud Boys and right-wing groups.
I gotta get one of these.
Rallied by Biggs and another leader, Ethan Nordine, known as Rufio, the Proud Boys coalesce and march on the Capitol. Nordine declined to comment.
Two men on a mission with about 500 behind them ready to kick some butt standing for this country.
Yeah, they got him. All right, man, I ain't finna watch this whole video, but they break it all the way down. They got it. They got him. I'm sure they done went through all kinds of tapes. But actually, people might not be privy to the actual fact that the leader of the Proud Boys, Enrique Tarrio, is... Two facts that people might not know about this guy. You know what I'm saying? Like, well, I'll pull it up and show you guys. These two facts that y'all might not have known. That I'm so happy to have in common with this Proud Boy. All right, you ready? Enrique Tarrio is his name. All right. Leader of the Proud Boys, international chairman, Enrique. So, definitely got Cuban descent, B. He's Cuban, B, but he's also black, B. Cuban and black, from Miami, Florida, born in the 80s, just like me. From Miami, just like me. But I'm not a Proud Boy. I'm proud to be who I am, but I'm not a Proud Boy. All right, so he's a Republican, and you can look him up. He's also a former FBI informant. So, yeah, is that a snitch? There's been a lot of FBI informants, man. Pros, everybody an FBI informant. What's up? Appreciate the love, DJ TC. Everybody FBI informant, man. It's like, is that the thing the thing to be? Is that, you know what I'm saying? An informant, Praz, Enrique Tario. These folks be getting a check from the FBI, don't they? They trying to say Rollo was snitching? I don't know. Don't say I need to look that up. Do I need to talk about Rollo snitching? It don't even really matter about snitching anymore in the rap game anyway. We don't even need to talk about that ever again. It don't even matter. Speaking of snitching, Ime Udoka has got a job at the Houston Rockets. Congratulations, maybe. Did he apologize to Neil Long? I can't celebrate that. All right. I can't celebrate that. But Ime Udoka is now the head coach of the Houston Rockets. Former Boston Celtic coach Ime Udoka lost the Celtic job, was suspended, and eventually released because he had an affair with someone a part of the organization. Now I'm saying that's all I'm gonna say, whatever, just to not be messy. But cheated on Neil Long, man, fine ass. And they got him up off the team and embarrassed Neil Long and embarrassed him. They didn't even have to take it all that far. But he back. He bite. And they say he might be coming for some of Boston Celtics players. So we'll keep an eye on that. But, the young brother got the job. Rest in peace to Tory Bowie, man. I told y'all this is a sad show this week. Tory Bowie, Olympic medalist, passed away mysteriously at the age of 32, I think yesterday or today. I don't know where I did see this. And I didn't want to forget because it's a lot of people that should be dying, man. You know what I'm saying? Gotta recognize the blessing of just even being alive, man. Thank y'all for y'all support. And rest in peace. Real quick, moment of silence for Tory Bowie. All right, so that's a piece of Tory Bowie. Okay, Ed Sheeran said he was about to quit music, but he'd end up not quitting because I guess he don't need to quit. He said he would quit music if he lost the case with him on his song Thinking Out Loud. The Marvin Gaye estate and Marvin Gaye's family was suing him for that song being similar to Let's Get It On and copyright infringement. And Ed Sheeran said he would quit music if it came out that he would lose this case. And y'all know that the Marvin Gaye and family, what's up, DJ2Q? Thank you for the love. On the first time chat, DJ2Q, she fucking with us. Yes. Anyway, but appreciate the love, DJ2Q. But, yeah, if y'all don't know, what y'all think? Do y'all think the song sounds similar? We can listen. Let me check it out real quick. Do y'all think it sounds similar or whatever? I don't know. I don't think so. Well, I don't know. It does kind of, but.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste?
There you go, DJ
QQ.
Can you hear it?
Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? Darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. And baby, my heart could still fall as hard at 23. push of a hand. Well, me, I fall in love with you every single day, and I just wanna tell you I am. So honey, now.
Okay.
Take me into
I definitely hear it. Okay, I definitely hear it. All right, Ed Sheeran. Surprisingly, I guess there ain't really no reason to even talk about this or whatever, because he said that he didn't steal this. But yeah, it definitely sound closer than Blurred Lines did. But Blurred Lines did sound close to. And you know, folks be doing that all the time. Them folks, you know what I'm saying, would be like, they'll come to the producer and be like, hey, remake this, make this sound just something like this, and then they'll sing the song kind of similar, but y'all better not mess with no Marvin Gaye song. I tell you that much. Y'all better not mess with, you know what I'm saying? I don't even want to play the music. This is for educational purposes only, because I don't even really, you know what I'm saying, I don't want to owe them folks nothing, but
I've been really trying, baby.
This is for educational purposes only. We just trying to compare.
Trying to hold back this feeling for so long.
What y'all think?
You feel like I feel, baby, then come on.
I mean, y'all, since we about to end the show anyway.
Let's get on. Let's love, baby.
All right. So y'all, she say that DJ Too Cute says, I'm a Marvin Gaye fan and I don't hear it. But say the Marvin Gaye estate is tripping. Say, yeah, let that man Eric Sharon live. Definitely.
So I sit down in the studio here today, and you know, I look at the news, and I see that Ed Sheeran's getting sued again for thinking out loud by Ed Townsend, who's a co-writer of Let's Get It On by Marvin Gaye. And this time it's a $100 million suit. The company that's suing him is called Structured Asset Sales. So the lawsuit alleges that the, melody, rhythms, harmonies, drums, bass line, backing chorus, tempo, syncopation, and looping are taken from Marvin Gaye. So let's take a listen to it. I'm starting out with Thinking Out Loud. Let's take a listen.
Baby, my it's still full as heart at 23.
Ooh.
Like I feel, baby.
All right, so yeah, very, 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 very similar. Inspired, maybe? Def? Hey, Sharon, I'm saying DJ QQ, DJ TCZ say he may hear it. I mean, DJs, you know what I'm saying? You know, I'm sure y'all, they're going to be coming with blends. And again, that was just for educational purposes only. The game is almost at halftime, man. I know some of y'all is probably watching the game and listening to us on the side. I'm going to let y'all go. Shout out to the halftime show. He say, sue his ass. Very, very close, right? I would say XYZ says it's very, very close. Right, so I want to get that part of the show in, but it says jury concludes that Ed Sheeran did not copy parts of Marvin Gaye's classic hit Let's Get It On. He definitely squeezed out of this one, and he was said he was gonna quit, you know. But so maybe that's a win. Maybe that's a win for music. Maybe it's a loss. We're not gonna talk about any AI. We're gonna go ahead and get up out of here, man, because it's getting kind of late. But Shout out to Joel Embiid for winning the NBA MVP. Who y'all got, man? We getting closer into the end. Lakers versus Warriors are playing right now, and I'm missing the game, so I'm finna click on over back to the game, see if Steph Curry, you know what I'm saying, can pull this one off, or do LeBron and Anthony Davis repeat the bubble performance. Also, James Harden showed up in game one and didn't show up in game two. I don't really want to talk about James Harden, but Joel Embiid making MVP almost forced this conversation. What's going to happen out of the Boston Celtics and Miami Heat is really the conversation I really want to talk. But first, we got to get to that point, you know. And the Knicks don't look like they want to lay down. So, you know, did the Heat play tonight? Maybe I already missed the game. I don't know. I might be talking old news. So I want to move on into the go Heat, come back Jimmy Butler. And I think that the Denver Nuggets is a very deep team, very slept on deep team. But they definitely have to pass the test, especially if they go against the big bright lights of LeBron James. And what would be a better finals, right? For those that say that the game is rigged, they'll never have a finals in Denver because no one will watch the finals. I mean, there's a two-time MVP that's on that team that definitely wants a ring. And they definitely have championship pedigree on that team as far as defensively and playoff experience wise. So we'll see how it goes. Denver, Jamal Murray actually got hurt during the bubble year and they might have missed their shot. So maybe this is the year that they come back. Pharrell took Marvin Gaye music too. okay, TC. Yes, right. They won that case. That's the case that they won, actually. And saying you used to go out to parties. All right, so we're going to close the show and get back to the game. It's Warriors 54, the Lakers 50. And speaking of 50, Steph Curry scored 50 in game seven. I'm saying first time that's ever been done. Congratulations to Steph, but he better come through against LeBron if he want to continue on his route to be a top 10. It's Steph, definitely, in my opinion, is a top 10 player. But if he beats LeBron, he definitely will be that nemesis to LeBron's great legacy. And so this series is a very big and, you know, very important series. It will go down in history. So I don't want to miss history. I want to get back to my blessings. I appreciate, you know what I'm saying, all the support. And everybody that's watching thus far on Twitch, make sure you tell a friend to tell a friend. We might be back on Saturday or whatever. Shout out to DJ TC. He'll be back tomorrow at 8 o'clock right here on Twitch and on Doja Toja Radio. Appreciate you, DJ TC, man. You know what I'm saying? I see a lot of folks ain't been listening on the Mitzler app, but, you know, we still going to rock on the Mitzler app because, hey, I got to get DJ TC show reels. I gotta fix his show reels, and I'm gonna start broadcasting more on Doja Toldya Radio and coming through, you know. But I do appreciate all the support that you guys have been giving through the Cash App, $DOZHATOLDYARADIO. I know I asked for the Cash App at the end of the show, but you can see it right there. It says the Cash App, where you can help and support a growing music platform. You know what I'm saying? Not only is it internet radio, we also have interviews. This is the DozhaToldya podcast you'll be supporting and more, man. You know what I'm saying? DozhaToldya.com. Log on to the website. It's all there and more. Like I said, you know, we got gallery, photo galleries, and shit, we're going to keep working, man. We're going to keep building, man. Putting together these great shows, trying to be a little bit more, you know, insightful, informative, and, you know, give y'all an experience with the music. And appreciate the support. Yeah, then the shit just rung off just then. Damn, y'all, that was quick. I appreciate the support, though, man. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you tell a friend, that listen to us every Thursday right here. It's the DozhaToldya Podcast. This is number 64. We're going to come back to number 65, and then we may take a quick little break. I don't know. We're thinking about taking a summer vacation for a couple of weeks. But we definitely don't want to miss the momentum, man. Shout out to ATM Julio, man. That last episode was a real, real good episode. But this one, we had some fun as well. But if you would like to be a guest on DozhaToldya Podcast and you're in the Atlanta area, hit us up at DozhaToldya@gmail.com. Let us know what you want to talk about, whatever. Let us know, saying we'll let you know if you qualify, whatever, to be on the show, and I'm saying how much it may be or whatever we need to do to get you on the show. We're gonna get you on the show, you know. And I appreciate everybody, whatever, you know what I'm saying, that have been watching and telling these folks that they need to get on the show. Steph Curry is up 57-50. They gave the Lakers 8 points. I meant to bet on this game, but I didn't, man. For those that do bet, you know what I'm saying, be careful with your money, man. You know what I'm saying? And good luck. Don't bet against Steph Curry, though, man. I don't know. That's like Tom Brady. That's like betting against Tom Brady, man. It's kind of hard. Kind of tough. Shout out to all everybody that's watching us on Twitch, man. Thank you, DJ 2Q, DJ TCZ, XYZZ, Mick Lovin, and more. Shout out to everybody that's also supporting me on the Mixler app. I'm about to get up out of here, man. I got one song that I wanted to play before I got up out of here, and I'm gonna figure out a way that y'all can actually hear it in the Mixler world. But this song was like, I've been thinking about this song all night by Giancarlo Pause. But very, very good song. Giancarlo Jackman is out right now. Y'all go check that album out. Albums, man. What happened to hip hop? I meant to have that as the main topic of this this show, but I kind of got beside myself. But Rocco had asked what happened to hip hop, and I ain't even get into that. But the women run hip hop right now. That's what probably happened to hip hop. Ain't nothing happened to hip hop. There's a lot of people making money, and so it's still one of the biggest, no, the biggest genre in music, and is making millionaires or whatever. A lot of folks is making millionaires. It's a brand new game. A lot of these folks, you know what I'm saying, don't know what they're doing, and once they drop the music and they don't want to come on the show or do no, you know, real work behind what they got going on, they don't want to listen to me, you know. And it's all right, you know. Shout out to DJ TC. I love what y'all did with the Raid Train too, man. Y'all, the DJ community on Twitch, that's the future. You know, I'm here for it, man. So this is, you know, my little channel, and we get down on DozhaToldya, man. So I appreciate everybody following me, and subscribers will come. We just got to build it. If you build it, they will come. Remember, the blessings, it won't come when you call them, but they will come eventually. And when they do come, take heed to your blessings, man. You know, give back. Because, you know, the blessings that you receive, you know, they say it's better to give. So give your blessings and you shall receive your blessings. And I'm just here trying to give my weekly blessing. It's the DozhaToldya Podcast. I appreciate all the support, man. We're going to get up out of here with Gang Gang, Gang Gang by Jack Harlow on the DozhaToldya Podcast, man. The Warriors up by 10, man. It's almost halftime show. So I know y'all good and greased. Man, we going to get up out of here. We're going to get up out of and play this Gang Gang. I appreciate it, y'all. See y'all tomorrow, next week. Hold on. I got to fix this.
Like, did you hear about Marcus? Marcus? Yeah, I'm Marcus.
What's up, y'all? It's your boy Dame Doja. If you're looking to get your interview done or be a guest host on our podcast, hit us up at DozhaToldya@gmail.com. Bump what you heard. Remember who told you? It's DozhaToldya.